Hello and welcome to this video overview of Diachromie, a look development plugin designed by HAL Picture. My name is Paul, I'm a cinematographer and one of the creators behind Diachromie. And today I will walk you through the plugin in a series of presentation videos. Diachromie handles the color aspect of look development. If you're interested in shaping the spatial or temporal aspects of your image, you should check out diaphany, and you could use grain or halation, for instance, in this plugin. But for now, let's focus on Diachromie. Once installed, Diachromie is available in the Effects panel of DaVinci Resolve. To use it, just add it to a node of your node graph. The plugin interface shows up on the right side of your window. We will first have a look at each of these sections. We'll then dive into the color management, so that at the end of this video, you're ready to start developing looks in a proper environment. Finally, we'll cover the preset feature, a powerful tool to share looks and build up on your experience in crafting complex and interesting looks. Let's start by the licensing section, since we need to bind the license key to activate the plugin. You can bind a license key to your station from here by clicking on this button and pasting the key. Once it's done, you have access to the license information in this button. You can also unbind your license key to free up a seat on your license. Be aware that the unbinding cannot be done remotely. You need access to the station to unbind it from your key. The core of the plugin is the color transformation section. It gathers all the look development modules. Contrast, color tone curves, vertex transformations, and effects. Each module addresses a coherent part of the color look, and we do a deep dive into all these modules in the following videos of this series. The monitoring tools regroups all the graphical tools that help understand and control the color transformations. We will talk more about them as well during each module deep dive. LUT export allows you to generate a kubelet file, including all the color transformations of your look. As with every LUT, it's not a perfectly transparent match since it's a discrete process, as opposed to the continuity of Diachromie's algorithms. When the resolution of the LUT is high enough, these differences become insignificant. A 65 LUT is considered a good threshold for log-to-log processing. You can also export LUTs directly from Resolve. For more information, you can check out the documentation on our website. Before diving into look development, we need to understand the way Diachromie integrates in your color workflow. This is where the color management section becomes of use. Diachromie is a log-to-log plugin. It takes a log image, applies color transformations to it, and outputs the modified image in the same log color space. Diachromie needs to live in a color managed workflow. It can happen at the project level, at a timeline level, or through a custom color management in the node graph. Right now, as I just created a new project in Resolve, there is no color management in place. This is why my demo images are all in a logarithmic state. Since Diachromie supports all common color managed workflows, we can address that in several ways. Diachromie itself operates in the ACCCT color space, and by default, the plugin does not do any internal color management. This means the plugin expects an ACCCT image as an input, and will output an ACCCT image. So I can go in the project settings, and I can configure a proper ACCCT workflow. I could also do that in the timeline settings or with AC's transform nodes, before and after the Diachromie plugin in the node graph. In any case, it's important to consider whether you need the AC's reference gamut compress. In AC's 1.3, you should use it every time because it deals very well with out-of-gamut values and it compensates for some of the DRT not exactly perfect behavior. In ACES 2, the need is less critical. Most colors are very well handled by the redesign of the DRT. Sometimes, on some products, it might still be useful if you deal with very highly saturated colors. So you need to assess for that, but it's not something you should definitely use every time. Once I have set up this color management, Resolve applies the proper color space conversion to my images. It can be detected automatically by camera metadata, or you can set it up by right-clicking on the thumbnail and choosing the proper AC's input transform. The display color space, Rec 709 in my case, was chosen in the project settings. If you want to use a different color manage workflow, you need to enable the internal color management in the plugin and then choose the appropriate working color space. In this mode, Diachromie internally converts your image from your working color space to ACCCT, applies the color transformations, and then converts back to your working color space. Once again, you have to provide properly color managed images to the plugin and choose an appropriate DRT, the rendering transform, to output a display image. If you have previous working habits or if your project requires a specific workflow, you might need to use internal color management. Otherwise, we recommend using ACCCT as a good starting point. Whether you like the AC's rendering or not is not really important, because the look development operations gives you a lot of control over the way the image will be rendered eventually. However, once you start developing your look, it is not advised to change your workflow, as it will likely change the DRT and so the final outcome of the image. Once you have properly configured your workflow, you can start your look development. As I said, we dive into every module in the following videos, and I recommend you start with the contrast module. It is often the first step in crafting a look from scratch. To make it easier to work with looks, to share them and to make them evolve over time, we have implemented a preset feature. Presets are XML files that store all the color transformation values of a given look at a given time, and you can manage them with the look preset section. The plugin comes with built-in presets. These are robust looks that we designed to cover a variety of visual identities. And we'll find them here in the list, prefixed with HAL, to identify them properly. Since we developed the plugins at a time where ACs 1.3 and ACs 2 were coexisting, we are shipping the plugin with two versions of each preset. That way you can easily migrate from ACs 1.3 to ACs 2 and get similar results out of the presets. To do so, you must select your chosen DRT in the HAL presets target list. Then you'll get access to the proper flavor of each preset. At the release of the plugins, we will also support the DaVinci Color Management DRT. You can load any built-in preset and then customize it. You can obviously also start from scratch or reset any or all parameter from the preset. At all time, you can export a preset of your current look. This is done by this button, Export Preset, and it will create a preset with all the color transformation values in an XML file. If you want to have an easy access to your preset in the future, you can add it to the User Preset folder. It's accessible with this button. Just drop a preset here, click Refresh User Presets, and your preset will appear in this list, prefixed by user in between brackets. This is how you create a preset library. If you want to load a preset without adding it to the library, just use the Load External Preset button here. Using a preset can be an excellent starting point for a faster look development. You can find the preset that is as close as possible to your desired outcome, and then customize it to get to that desired look. Thanks to the power and depth of each of our modules, you'll be very easily able to customize a preset to get to a unique look and feel, but you will still be founded on a robust look development from the preset. Finally, to add even more modularity, you can load a preset directly from within the module, and this will load the values of the preset just for the given module. This gives you a lot of flexibility. You can, for instance, load a contrast curve from a preset that you actually like and mix it with maybe some customized color tone curves or some vertex transformations that you would load from another preset and then change or offset a bit. To keep track of which preset you've used in the modules, there's a tool here in the look preset section that shows which preset has been called last and if it's been modified or not. For instance, if I load a preset in the contrast module, it will show up here. And if I modify it, you'll get a little asterisk that tells you that it's not the original values, it's been modified. Gives you a bit of a memory of the way you built your look. We find that this modular aspect of presets is essential in look development. It lets you build up on your experience to save time and, most importantly, to go one step further every time you start a new look. So we really encourage you to make the most of these presets and create your own preset library as you get acquainted with the plugin. So this wraps up our first look at Diachromie. In the next videos, we'll look into the color transformation modules. Thank you for watching.